In this video, we are going to discuss the basics of PCR cloning. The invention of PCR in the mid-1980s revolutionized molecular biology. Some scientists had been testing in vitro replication assays when the remarkable enzyme TAC polymerase was discovered. TAC revolutionized these attempts at in vitro DNA replication because it is stable at extremely high temperatures. It became possible to target the replication of specific sections of DNA by defining the region of interest with short oligonucleotide primers, and then controlling the events in the test tube by modulating the temperature. We are now in the age of whole genome sequencing, and vast datasets of reference genomes exist. Thus, a typical way a cloning project might begin is to determine the gene you are studying, make PCR primers, and generate a PCR product. A purified PCR product is a suitable transformative reagent for some experiments. In other experiments, the PCR product needs to be captured and used as a building block for subsequent molecular constructs. It is important to realize that any purified PCR product is actually a population of fragments. Mutations have accumulated at some rate, depending on the polymerase you used. Within the population of fragments, mutations will be masked because the majority of the fragments will be accurate. If you need to capture your PCR product to proceed, you are capturing one particular molecule out of that population. Therefore, you must verify the sequence to be sure that your molecular construct is based on an accurate PCR clone. We will now take a few minutes to outline the different ways PCR products can be cloned. We will go into more detail in subsequent videos. A very direct way to clone a PCR product is to take advantage of restriction sites that are native to your fragment of interest. This is, of course, limited to the restriction enzyme sites that are already in or adjacent to your target gene. A more flexible alternative is to add restriction enzyme sites to the ends of your PCR primers. This allows you to put the enzyme sites of your choice exactly where you want them. Whether you are using native restriction enzyme sites or engineered sites, your cloning procedure would proceed with digestion, fragment purification and ligation, and on into the cloning cycle. Now let's take a look at non-restriction enzyme-based ways to clone PCR products. One of the most popular ways to clone a PCR product is called TA cloning. As it turns out, standard TAC polymerase frequently leaves an extra untemplated A at the 3' end of the PCR product. A category of cloning vectors have been developed to take advantage of this untemplated A. These vectors are purchased pre-linearized with a complementary T overhang, and ligation is driven with ligase. This technique is referred to as TA cloning. A more efficient variant of TA cloning is topo TA cloning. In this case, ligation is driven by the enzyme topoisomerase. Use of topoisomerase is highly efficient in ligations, with ligations complete after 5 minutes at room temperature. While original topo cloning vectors required TA overhangs, equally robust variants now allow blunt-end topo cloning and directional topo cloning. Topo TA vectors are purchased in a ready-to-use format, linearized with topoisomerase attached to the ends of the vector. A couple of key points about topo cloning. Topoisomerase is poised to complete one catalytic event. It can only complete this event when its binding site is filled with substrate, including the insert. Thus, there is typically little to zero background when topo cloning. Sequences of TA and topo TA vectors are included in SnapGene and can be found by opening the Actions menu and selecting TA or topo TA cloning. No matter which technique you use to capture a PCR product, this is frequently just a first step in a longer cloning experiment. You would, of course, proceed with the other steps in the cloning cycle until you have a sequenced verified clone that meets the demands of your upcoming experiment. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.